A Philippine congressional leader says 10 government agencies will be affected by the move to realign confidential and intelligence funds to agencies guarding the country's waters. House Appropriations Panel Vice Chair Stella Kimbo did not say which agencies are affected, only that the funding rationalization is still underway. This means some agencies will see lower intel funds, but Kimbo notes nothing is final yet. Kimbo is a member of the small committee tasked to make amendments. The House leadership agreed to reallocate surveillance funds to agencies patrolling the West Philippine Sea amid maritime tensions with China. A Philippine lawmaker calls on his colleagues to reallocate some confidential funds to agencies that provide basic services. Albay Representative Edsel Lagman says while it is good to boost funding for agencies protecting the country's maritime territory, the government should not neglect its other welfare projects such as health and education.
Ako ay hindi tumututol sa pag-reallocate dun sa mga agencies na nagbibigay ng nag-protect ng Philippine interest sa West Philippine Sea. Pero huwag masyadong marami sapagkat yung funds should be reallocated to basic agencies like education, itong labor, itong agriculture, at other services like health, kailangan yan. For example, sa education, kailangan ka mag-reallocate ng funds upang meron tayong pundo para sa school site acquisition. Sa Department of Health, dagdagan natin yung medical assistance program.
Lagman's remark comes after House leaders decided to realign civilian agencies' secret funds to those tasked to ensure national security. But Lagman believes pouring in more budget is not enough to counter China's aggression.
No amount of confidential funds can tame a bully. No amount of confidential funds can resolve the issue of Chinese existence and occupancy of Philippine territories, the West Philippine Sea, as awarded by the arbitrary tribunal. Kailangan meron tayong other peaceful means. At ako ay nagsasuggest na we should have or implement a calibrated economic sanction against China.
An oil price rollback is expected next week, the second one after an 11-week streak of fuel price increases, in fact. Now, estimates show a liter of gasoline could be cheaper by as much as 2 pesos and 30 centavos per liter, while kerosene may see an increase of up to 60 centavos per liter. But for diesel, prices may go up by at least 20 centavos. It's never too late to finish one's education. This is why social enterprise Inspiro is helping employees in the business process outsourcing industry fulfill their dream of getting a college degree. Victoria Tula joins us on the line for details. Hi, Victoria. What's going on?
Hi, Stanley. Recognizing that a big number of employees in the business process outsourcing industry do not have a college degree, a social enterprise called Inspiro has stepped in to help address this issue. Ever since 2019, Inspiro has offered a college degree in business administration for employees in the BPO industry. In an event today entitled Rekindled Hope, Inspiro Convocation 2023, the first three batches of Inspiro graduates were recognized while a new batch was welcomed. Inspiro's founder and principal consultant, Gabriel Orendain, says employees with a minimum of 5 years working experience in the sector are encouraged to take part in the 8-month program, which is conducted in partnership with the Cebu Institute of Technology University and Philippine Women's University. Learning is purely online, giving students flexibility to work and study at the same time. The program is also accredited by the Commission on Higher Education through its expanded tertiary education equivalency and accreditation program. Inspiro's partner company, Optum Philippines, a health services company, fully supports the participation of their employees in the program, which is why it reimburses them for the tuition and fees. Optum Managing Director Ivic Moeco said they greatly believe in the personal and professional growth of their employees. Majority of the 117 graduates come from Optum. One of them is 30-year-old Aubrey Diane Dimalibot, who was not able to finish her studies because of financial constraints. She grabbed the opportunity to enroll in the program and finally earned a college diploma last year. After graduating, Aubrey was promoted from quality analyst to supervisor. She is also currently pursuing a law degree. For Orenbain, achieving a college degree is not just about obtaining a piece of paper, but about empowering individuals to lead purposeful and fulfilling lives. He hopes to expand the program soon by including overseas Filipino workers who would also want to finish their tertiary education. Aside from guests from the IT and BPO industry, ABS-CBN Chief Operating Officer for Broadcast, Ms. Cory Vidanes, also graced the event. Stanley?
All right. Thank you so much for the update, Victoria Tulad. Moving on, a recent survey says at least 50% of Filipino adults are dissatisfied with the K-12 curriculum. A teachers group believes the figure could be higher. Teachers Dignity Coalition Chairperson Benjo Basa says the Education Department should identify areas where the program failed. Basa adds the curriculum's goal is to equip students with the necessary skills to make them competitive. It's not translating to success in the jobs market.
Kailangan talaga pag-aralan. At dapat yung edi magkaroon ng honest na review, saan siya nagkulang, saan ba tayo patungo kung pag-uusapan natin ang education na sector natin. In the end, desisyon na natin.
The Philippine Environment Department suspends its land agreement deal with the controversial Socorro Bayanihan Group in Surigao del Norte. The deal was awarded to the group in 2004, which covers 353 hectares of land. But the DENR says the group has violated some terms of the agreement, including the establishment of checkpoints within the leased area. Now, a Senate probe over the alleged cult group's criminal activities, such as child marriage and rape, is also underway. Meanwhile, the police have increased security in the town pending this investigation.
So far, wala naman po, ma'am, normal po, manageable po, nandun po lahat yung mga PNP natin, nag-deploy na po tayo ng karagdagang pwersa po. Hindi po yung sabihin na magulo po, hindi po, kung hindi, ayusin lang po natin na maibawasan yung mga baka may magaganap po na kaguluhan. Yun lang po na dapat magkaroon kami ng sa active sa investigation at saka yung sa ano natin yung kailangan maayos yung pagkakandak ng security natin doon sa area. Kailangan na dagdagan, kung kailangan dagdagan, dagdagan ng pwersa. Saka mag-maintain tayo ng 24 hours na checkpoint operation para po ma-maintain natin yung kasiguruhan at saka yung kausayan ng sa lugar po na walang mangyari po.
Members of the Socorro Bayanihan Group gave mixed reactions on the suspension of their land agreement by the Environment Department. The majority wants to stay in the community while others want to hear government's plan. Nico Bawa has this story.
DNR has suspended the Protected Area Community-Based Resource Management Agreement of the DNR with the Socorro Bayanihan Services Incorporated. According to the DNR, they will have to investigate the allegations of having a private army, the strictness of the organization in the mobility of the members, where they allegedly can go in and out of the area, the problems with the resignation of the teachers and the policemen who have gone up to the community, and all the other allegations. So DNR says they have to conduct an investigation first. And while they are suspending the agreement, that agreement allows the SBSI members to stay or reside in the mountain, which they granted to the group in 2004. And that agreement or contract is supposed to last till 2029 or 25 years. So we were able to talk with some of the members of SBSI, and they had mixed reactions about it. Some of the members, or actually more, a majority of the members would rather stay in the mountain because they've been living there for short as 3 years, but the others have been living there since the 80s. So prefer to live there because most of their families are there, their livelihood is there, and then their houses are there too. But some of the members want a clear plan from the government on what they plan to do with them in case if they pursue relocation for the members, especially since there's 4,000 residents of the SBSI there. So they want to know if the relocation, planned relocation eventually, if there's a place for them to live, if there's a housing project, if there's a livelihood program for there. So they have so many questions on what will happen to them. According to the officials of the SBSI, they would have to meet with their officers about the suspension order of the DNR, but their officials are currently being detained by the Senate. The DNR, however, says they will have to talk to the DSWD, the DILG, and the other pertinent organ, government agencies to plan out and take steps on what they plan to do with all the residents there and how are they going to conduct the investigation on those allegations.